Hello guys, this test series contains the physics in which I am taking the error analysis questions which are generally asked in previous years engineering examinations, and I am discussing those questions one by one. You can follow me. One thing more, I take some more extra questions which are little bit tricky etc. in this video, so please keep a watch. Okay. First question, if relative errors in the mass and the length of a cube is 1.5% and 1%, find the error in calculating the density. Now just see again in the question, that is error in the mass is 1.5% and error in the length is 1%, and the object is the cube. Object is the cube. That means length, breadth and height, both are equal. All are equal. Find the error in calculating the density. Now what is the formula of density? I think you know, mass per unit volume. And the volume is what? Length into breadth into height. And in case of cube, the volume is equals to L cube. And now I am just writing the formula. I think you know very well. That means density is equal to mass over volume. That means our results become m over l cube. Now error, I think you know, in case of error we have delta m over m plus 3 delta l over l. Here I write the plus because not in the minus, because it is in the denominator. It should be in minus, but I never write minus here because in errors nothing should be subtracted. Everything must be added. Errors are also added. Always added. Okay. Now delta m by m is what? 1.5%. Clear? And delta l, that is 1%. That means 3 into 1. Now we have 1.5 plus 3. That my error is 4.5%. Clear? Okay. Now I am proceeding to the second question, journals. Now watch the next question on your screen. Calculate the error in the surface tension. And formula for surface tension is given here. RHG upon 2 into 10 to the power 3. I just rubbed the unit Newton per meter. Just to tell you, RHG over 2 into 10 to the power 3. This question is actually asked in the IIT examination, but I write the question in a precise way. Only the things which are needed I write here. Okay, so the formula for tension, surface tension, is RHG over 2. Clear? Where diameter, because in surface tension we have a capillary tube which has some diameter and the water ascends that in capillary tube. So the diameter of the capillary tube is this. And the rise of water due to surface tension is this. And so we have to find the surface tension. Now, here is the diameter. And in our formula, we have RHG over 2. Same thing. Into 10 to the power 3. Now, this 10 to the power 3, 2 and G. G is the gravity. All are constant quantities. So we just ignore that. So formula remains R into H. Now this is the radius and we have the formula diameter. So in place of R, we write D over 2 into H. That means against 2 is a constant. Okay, just we ignore that. Now to find the error, we have delta D over D plus delta H over H. So simple. Okay. Into 100. Clear? Now we just put the values and find out the error. I'm solving this for you one by one. Just see over here. Now see delta D. For delta D, D is what? 1.25 into 10 to the power minus 2. From here we find delta D. That is what? 0.01. 0.01 into 10 to the power minus 2. Clear? When delta D is not given, we just find it this way. Okay? Now we have 0.01 into 10 to the power minus 2 over 1.25 into 10 to the power minus 2. Clear? Now similarly, delta H. Now calculate the delta H yourself. I think you can easily calculate now. That means H is equal to 1.45 into 10 to the power minus 2. That means delta H is what? 0.01 into 10 to the power minus 2. Clear? Now write the values. 0.01 into 10 to the power minus 2. After we write 1.45 into 10 to the power minus 2, and we just multiply both the quantities with 100. Now this get cancelled, this get cancelled. Now I am going to solve one by one. See on the blackboard. I am just rubbing the question. Okay. Now we have 0.01 over 1.25 into 100. Clear? These two get cancelled. We have 100 over 125. Cut it down with the help of 5. 20, 25. 4 over 5. That means 0.8. Clear? Just write 0.8 plus. Easy? So tough digits, and very easily they are get solved. Because in physics, we learn easily the theories. But I make videos which have only numericals. If I am successful in teaching you how to solve these numericals, then it gives me happiness. And if you like that you can learn anything, please subscribe my videos. Okay, then it is 100 over 145. That means 5 to the 10, 0. 5 to the 10, 5 nines are 45. Now do it by divide. Clear? 0.0. For example, 9, 1, 8, 18, 26. So 9 is not there. Now with 8. 8 times are 72, 8 to the 16, 23. So 8 will not be there. Now 7. 7 nines are 63, 6, 7 to the 14, 6, 20. Approximately 0.7. That means we have 1.5%. Clear? Now note it down. Now see the another question. Find accuracy of g, that means gravity. If the formula is time period is equal to 2 pi under root L by g, where length is 20.0 centimeter and time for 100 oscillation is 90 seconds. That means in doing 100 oscillations, the time taken is 90 seconds and 1 second is the accuracy. Now we have to find g, and we have the formula 2 pi under root L over g. So ignoring this, we have t is equals to under root L over g. Now square, 2 square is equal to L over g. That means z is equal to L over t square. That means delta g over g is equals to delta L over L plus 2 delta T over T. As I told earlier, errors are always positive. So this is the place where we have to put the values. Now I am searching the values in the question. Now see the question again. We have length 20.0. That means length is 20.0 centimeter and nothing is given. That means delta L is what? 0.1 centimeter. we have one decimal place. Clear? Now, this is a tough task. 100 oscillations is 90 seconds. What is the actual value we measure in our watch? That is, we find it is 90 seconds. This is the true value. That means T is what? 90 seconds. And what is delta T? That means here it is given 1 second resolution. That means delta T is 1 second. And there is no use of 100 in our question. Clear? Now just, it's very easy. We can do easily. Now just put the values. Delta G over G is equals to, we have delta L over L plus 2 delta T over T. That means we have 0.1 over 20.0 plus 2 into 1 over 90 multiplied by 100 in the same way as we do earlier. Now I am going to solve one by one. We just ignore the 100 here. We just take only the value 90 seconds, which is the true value which we measured. Okay? This is the main thing in that question. Now I am solving 0.1 over 20.0 into 100. I just told you when after this we have 0, we just ignored it. So we have now 10 over 20. That means we have 0.5. Clear? Now next one, 2 into 100 over 90. That means it is cut down. We have 20 over 9. That means 9 to the 18, then 29 to the 18 this way. Now we have to these two. So we have overall 2.7%. This is the percentage of gravity accuracy. That means if we have in options 3, then we tick the 3. Okay, just write down and don't skip the video. I'm going to take some more questions which are very important and very different from these concepts. Now see this type of question. A little bit seems tougher, having E, etc. How we'll solve that? Question is, if I is equals to E 1000 V over T minus 1, that means minus 1 written over here, minus 1. If there is error of this 0.01 V, this is the error in voltage, that is, this is the value of delta V, because it is in front of this, it is written over plus minus. So this is not the value of V, this is the value of delta V. While measuring the current 5 milliampere, but here there is no plus minus. So this is the value of current, that is I. And what is the error in current where T is this? That means analysis is what? Delta V, I write in this way. Delta V is what? 0.01. Clear? And I is what? 5 milliampere. And temperature is 300 K. And we have to measure delta I, okay? And V is not given. This is the error analysis. And see how we do that. Whenever we have exponent, that means ready to take the log, and in order to solve the logs, ready to differentiate, okay? Now just see on the blackboard how we solve this question. This is a different type of error analysis. Okay, now I is equals to E 1000 V over T minus 1. Just bring 1 here. We have I plus 1 is equals to E to the power 1000 V over T. When we take log on the both sides, it becomes log of I plus 1. But here it get cancelled and we simply have 1000 V over T. Note this step. This is the initial step whenever we have the values in the exponent. Clear? Now, in order to remove log, we just differentiate on both the sides. So, we have di over I plus 1. And here we have 1000 over t. This is the constant value. And v becomes du. Understood? Okay. Now, see. I'm not removing this. We have to find the value of di. Clear? So we multiply I plus 1 with that. I plus 1 into 1000 over t over d. Clear? I think it's become easy now. Now value of I, 5. 5 plus 1. Then 1000. Value of t, 300. And value of delta v, that is dv, into 0.01. Clear? Now, it's so easy. You can calculate it easily. And we find the percentage of error in the current. That is 6 into 1000 into 0.01 over 300. We remove this, two zeros are there, three get cancelled, six fives are 30, and we left over with 1/5, that means 0.2%. Clear? Now delta. Sorry, we have to find the current, so write it in milliampere. Okay. Watch another question. Time period measured by a boy is 90 seconds, 91 seconds, 92 seconds, 95 seconds. These are types of question. We indicates that there is a person who find the values for a particular time, particular thing for several times. That means he is doing some experiment. And one after another, he found the value 90 second, then for the same thing, he found 91, then he found 92, then he found 95. If the minimum division is 1 second, okay, find the reported mean time. We have to find the reported mean time. In these types of question, actually, we have to find the absolute error. Firstly, we find the mean. We just add all the observations with each other. Just like as we find the mean in small classes, in a statistic. And 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now add up all these things. 5, 2, 7, 1, 8. 9, 4, so 36 over 4. That means we have 92 seconds. Clear? That means whenever we write a reported time, we write A plus delta A. That means the value for A is 92. That is fixed. Now we have to find the value for delta A. Now how we find the value of delta A? We just subtract 92 with each observations. Clear? Which is known as absolute mean. That means 92 minus 90, then plus 92 minus 91, plus 92 minus 92, plus, I'm just rubbing this part, 95 minus 92 over 4. Same way we just divide by the 4. So we left over with 2, 1, 0 and 3 over 4. That means we have 2, 1, 3, 3, 3, 6 over 4. That means we have 3 by 2. That is, we have 1.5. So the reported time is what? As we have minimum division 1 second and the time is 1.5, that is greater than 1 second. But we don't have any 1.5 seconds. We have 1 second, 2 second, 3 second. So our answer should not be 1. Our answer should be 2. So the reported right time is what? 92 plus minus 2 seconds. This is our reported time. Okay, the option in which it is written, we just click that option. Okay. Now there's a question also on the blackboard, just a tricky one. Volume is equal to L into 2L into 3L and L is given as 1%. Find the error percent in volume. So don't be confused, don't write 6. But as we have 2 into 3 into L cube. Clear? That means we have 6L cube. But in error analysis, we just ignore the constant quantities. We have L cube. That means in error, we have 3 delta L over L. So our answer is 3 into 1%. That is, our answer is 3% and not the 6%. Similarly, I am going to take one more question.